Now, I want to move from the discussion of the empirical evidence, which I think we've seen is quite strong in this core message of the relationship between secure property rights and growth, to the kind of extension of the property rights paradigm into the area of sustainable growth and what I sometimes call the return of resources, or the return of Ricardo. In the late 20th century and now in the 21st century, I think the concerns about the potential limits to growth and ecological limits have come back, and we, with growing population, with concerns about land degradation. This is not a view that's shared by all. Some believe that technological and institutional innovation can be extended much farther, and that scarcity is not necessarily binding. But I think one of the things that everybody can agree on is that critical ecosystem service values are frequently not included up in the bundle of rights and responsibilities of the land tenure and property rights systems that we have inherited from the past. A past which did not necessarily require or have a demand for the definition and the valuing of those areas. Or we may have missing markets, like in the case of carbon, which are not accounted for in the values that we that our current land and property rights systems give to certain resources. And therefore, I think what we're seeing globally is a move to expanding and further specifying the bundle of rights and responsibilities, which I think is quite of a piece with the overall historical evolution. Examples of things like REDD+, where value on forest carbon is being made, or payment, other payment for ecosystem services schemes are creating, extending the property rights paradigm into additional aspects of the land-based assets. And I think we're seeing more and more that these ecosystem service values are now being recognized and extended into this, included into this extended bundle of rights and responsibilities. For example, the payment for in mangrove areas for the improvement of water quality and biodiversity that the mangrove provides to a community is now increasingly being seen as a value, and communities are able to monetize that in things like payment for ecosystem services schemes. And I think that's an important development in the extension of this land and property rights paradigm into the sustainable growth and the environmentally sensitive growth that's becoming more and more of a priority in the global agenda.